Hi, thank you for watching the Audio Design Desk Triggers tutorial. You can see I have this sword fight scene from the movie Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon. Now, swords are usually comprised of two parts, the whip of the sword, the whoosh, and the clanging of two swords. So I'm going to place both of those on triggers, and then I'm going to perform this scene to show you how they work. So first, let's type in whip. Now, lots of different kinds of whips are going to show up, so I'm going to need to narrow down my results or listen. And if I like the sounds I hear, I can make a selection and drag them in to trigger number one. Alternatively, I can search for our sound effects through category, subcategory, type, and subtype. So in this case, I know I want a sound effect. Stems are regions comprised of multiple elements. So for example, if you had a piece of audio that had 15 footsteps on it, we would call that a stem. Each individual footstep we call an element. So in this case, we're looking for elements, and I know that we're looking for weapons, and I'm looking for swords. Let's see. I can see that sword hitting sword is a sound here, and I can audition them. And if I like the sound, I can right-click and I can say assign trigger for sound to number two. And now all of those sounds are in my trigger number two. A third way of placing triggers is to search from within the trigger menu itself. So sound effects, fighting, female efforts. We'll place all of the female efforts inside of trigger number three. I can audition these sounds one at a time. And if I don't like the sound, I simply hit delete. And when I click number three, it won't call upon that sound. This way, I can narrow the sounds to just the ones I like. Now, I'm going to click play, and I'm going to perform pressing number one, two, and three while watching the video. By clicking the letter L, I can watch the video in half speed to increase my chances of being perfectly in sync. So now we'll watch the video in half speed. And in a moment, we'll listen back. And here's what we made. This is the beginning of understanding how triggers work in Audio Design Desk.